tensions are escalating between the governor of Puerto Rico and President Trump during a closed-door meeting with Republicans. President Trump complained about the amount of disaster relief going to the island in the wake of Hurricane Maria. And in this exclusive CNN interview, the governor of Puerto Rico is giving a clear warning to President Trump.
Does it feel that way sometimes? That you're dealing with a bully?
If the bully gets close, I'll punch the bully in the mouth.
Just like that.
Just like that. It would be a mistake to confuse courtesy with courage.
It has been a delicate dance for this governor as he continues to push for more funding for recovery efforts on the island. CNN chief White House correspondent Jim Acosta was the one who scored that exclusive interview. And Jim, what else did the governor say?
Well, Brooke, the reason why the governor said that is, they're frustrated inside his office. There were aides over here with the governor's office just yesterday at the White House talking to officials over here about setting up a meeting between the president and Ricardo Rosselló. And according to these officials with the Puerto Rican government, they were essentially lashed out against. And that top White House officials, including Peter Navarro, were telling them, listen, all of these cries coming from you guys and the governor that this is, quote, effing things up. They did not take too kindly to that. And as you heard the governor there say, he's not going to tolerate his officials being bullied. Now, I will tell you, Brooke, that the governor is here in Washington trying to promote this idea of Puerto Rican statehood. There's a new bill that's being introduced in the House to that effect today, because the governor says, listen, the reason why they received such short shrift from the government is because they're a U.S. territory. Even though they're American citizens, they don't have the same kind of political leverage that a state has. And in the words of Governor Rosselló, they feel like second-class citizens. Here's what he had to say.
Do you think the president treats people of Puerto Rico as citizens?
Well, treats us as second-class citizens. That's for sure. And my, my consideration is, I just want to have the opportunity to explain to him why the data and information that he's getting is wrong. I don't think getting into a kicking and screaming match with the president does any good. I don't think. Anybody can beat the president on a kicking and screaming match. I think that what I am aiming to do is making sure that reason prevails, that empathy prevails, that equality prevails, and that we can have a discussion.
Now, Brooke, officials over here at the White House have told us, they're pushing back. They're saying that the governor's team was not threatened over this issue of a meeting between the president and Rosselló, but they are not at this point committing to setting up that kind of meeting between the president and Governor Rosselló. They're saying that they hope to get a meeting for the governor sometime in the near future, but not necessarily with the president. And we should point out to our viewers, despite the fact that they suffered one of the biggest hurricanes, one of the deadliest and costliest hurricanes in U.S. history, they have only received a fraction of the tens of billions of dollars that territory needs to get back up on its feet. They're still languishing down there in Puerto Rico, waiting for help from the federal government, and it's just not coming, and they're really frustrated with all of this, and I think you're seeing some of that play out in that interview we had with the governor earlier today, Brooke.
Would punch him in the mouth. That is quite the soundbite. Quickly, Jim, have you heard anything back from this this administration on that?
Not yet. Now, the president is about to leave in just a few moments. He's going to be heading to Michigan for a rally later on tonight. I suspect he'll be asked about some of these concerns coming from the governor's office, and we'll wait and see. But remember, Brooke, he was on Capitol Hill earlier this week, really, diminishing the need in Puerto Rico for the kind of money that they need to get back out on their feet. And the president was essentially saying, we've given too much to Puerto Rico already. Why are we giving them so much money? And Rosselló is saying that that is basically treating the people of his island like second-class citizens, Brooke.
Jim Acosta, thank you very much.